Hi, I'm Nathan Zamprogno. I was elected as a Liberal to Hawkesbury Council 5 years ago, but I am proudly standing as an independent with my team of independent voices at the council elections on December 4. I have offered a different kind of representation never before seen in this area. I know that most of you don't have the time or inclination to follow council affairs. You all lead busy lives. But I think that you're tired of elected councillors who sit there for years and when election time comes, you can't tell what they stood for or how they voted or how hard they've been working for you over the term of council. Some of them barely turn up. And I think that we agree that that is not good enough. So I pledged to change that. I have engaged you on all of the important issues with videos, email newsletters and on Facebook. I've stood up for our area on the TV and radio, and I've never been afraid to stand up to both the state and federal governments when they've made stupid decisions. Now, you'll shortly be invited to cast your votes in unprecedented circumstances. The Electoral Commissioner has now declared that no one is going to be allowed to hand out any material outside polling places. So it's going to be even harder to know what the different groups stand for. And our fear is that you'll just wander into a polling booth and vote for one of the big brands because that's what you tend to do for state or federal elections. So my challenge to you is this. If the other councillors or candidates haven't been explaining themselves to you over the last 5 years, like I have, why would you vote for them? If they've made no effort to demonstrate that they can take complex issues and fairly present both sides, think carefully. If you've noticed that their views look predetermined by their ideological allegiances rather than arising from genuine consultation and acceptance of the evidence, be wary. I have absolutely loved the work of helping to make the Hawkesbury a better place, and I'm asking for your support to continue that work at the coming election. If you generally vote Liberal or Labor at state or federal elections but think that council shouldn't be tied up in party politics, I agree, and I voted with my feet. Remember, you're electing 12 councillors. I recommend that you vote for multiple tickets above the line, or better still, vote below the line. And we've all got our leanings, and I own mine, but I am an honest voice and not a kept man. And God knows that there's still so much that needs improving. If you're cranky that your council rates have spiked and don't feel that you get much back for them, I've fought for you by voting against every rate rise. If you're concerned that the pressure for urban sprawl is squeezing what makes the Hawkesbury such a special place to live, I'm beside you. If you think that we need to keep an eye on the effects of property speculation and land banking and foreign ownership in our area, don't go looking for sympathy from the major parties because you won't get it. And if you're baffled that our planning laws are so backward that you can put a granny flat in a tiny backyard in Bligh Park but can't build one for your elderly parents or your kids on an acreage lot, I feel like I'm the only one that's been trying to change this, and it's such an obvious area for reform. If you think that what passes for urban design these days increasingly leaves us with pokey, ugly monstrosities, I have been advocating for what we call design excellence principles, so that we can create built communities that we can be proud of, that are leafy and energy efficient and socially connected and compatible with the landscape instead of eating it whole. If you've ever put in a DA and were frustrated that the process took 6 months too long, and worse, that the council kept on shifting the goalposts on you and wouldn't return your calls or emails, let me share with you 100 different stories that show that you're not alone and that we need a big improvement to council's customer service culture. If you value the Hawkesbury's heritage and were disgusted that the Liberal and Labor councillors tried to abolish our heritage committee, I was the one who dug my heels in and saved it. If you're disappointed that the Redbank developers have broken their promise to build the Gross River Bridge by now, or that council were fool enough to let them, I kicked up the stink about that, and I am committed to getting the damn thing finished. If you think that it's poor that our council only gives you one free curbside pickup a year when our neighbours get four, vote for change. If you're suffering from expensive fees for sewage pump out or septic inspection, I want us to reform our approach. I mean, at the very least, we could open up our inspections to a competitive market and drive down the price instead of council's current monopoly. If you were angry when the state government tried to drive through road corridors that would carve up our suburbs, no one did more than me to explain the issues and, through quiet diplomacy, get the state government to change their mind. If you're disgusted at the state of our roads, I fought for and won significant funding to seal roads that I was told that would remain at the bottom of the list forever. So I'm asking you, what road sealing or improvement project would you like me to champion for you in the coming term of council? If you lament that the debate about flood mitigation seems split between environmentalists and developers, and that the missing voice in the debate is our community, the one enduring the greatest flood risk in Australia, then vote for somebody who speaks for our community. I've worked hard to raise the awareness of the need for flood safety measures, including, but not limited to, raising Warragamba Dam, while opposing inappropriate development on the floodplain. If you think that planning panels mean that our development decisions have been taken away from council and given to bureaucrats who don't necessarily even live in the area and who aren't accountable to you, and that this erodes our agency and our democracy in important planning decisions, good luck getting sympathy from the Liberals. I mean, this is an area where I have differed sharply with my colleagues, and I've explained why. They have not. If you think that Australia Day should be celebrated on Australia Day, I took a stand on that issue. And if you live in a part of the Hawkesbury that has been poorly represented by council, then please let me introduce my team. I am from Oakville, but my team includes Ben Newton, who is a school teacher who grew up in Yarramundi and lives in Grosvale, and Bindi Corp. She's a professional who's worked all over the world but comes from Bilpin. James Jackson worked in banking and has huge executive experience, and he is from Tennyson. Donna Pellew is an extraordinary local businesswoman who owns two businesses, the Richmond Currajong Florist in the main street of Richmond and Unique Floral and Events, and is from Wilberforce. And Zedekiah Sparks is a thoughtful young academic and activist from Currajong Heights. I am incredibly proud of my team and what we stand for. We promise independent voices and good government. We're looking forward to introducing ourselves to you and explaining what we stand for over the coming weeks. So look for some material in your letterbox really soon. I know that people barely pay much attention to local government, and I get it. But once every 4 or 5 years, we feel the need to kind of shout a little, because local government is really important. It affects our future. It affects what the Hawkesbury will look like in the years ahead. The election is December 4th, with early voting already underway. Details are at my website. Please follow me and my team for updates. There's more important information that we want to share with you over the coming days. Thanks for watching.